Imagine there was a magnificent, beautiful, historic building in a small, powerless country. The building was enjoyed by all. People would come from all over the world to bask in the glory of this building, to take tours, to walk through it. One day, a group of terrorists came and took over the building. They laid siege to the building, they plundered the building, they put the building into complete disrepair. The people in this country were so upset. They contacted the press, they made a big ruckus, they contacted whoever they knew, they tried to get any foreign government to come in and help them out. There was a country that was sympathetic to their cause. They sent a general and a powerful army to take over the building from the terrorists and to restore it to the people in the country. The general and the army came, they fought a tremendous battle, and eventually the terrorists were defeated and the building was returned to the people. There was great celebration in the street. The people came and they took the general and they gave him a private tour of the building. As the general passed through the building, he came to the foundations of the building and he saw that they were cracked. The building couldn't last too much longer. The general was astonished. He couldn't understand, why are the people so happy? Why are they celebrating? This building's gonna fall apart in a short time anyway. Chanukah is the time of the rededication of the second Beis HaMikdash. The second Beis HaMikdash was only a temporary structure. It was never meant to be permanent. That's why in the Kodesh HaKadoshim, the Holy of Holies, in the second Beis HaMikdash, there was no Aron. The Holy Ark didn't exist. Hashem Shechina, His presence, never truly rested in the second Beis HaMikdash. This begs this very same question. If the time period of the second Beis HaMikdash and the time period of Chanukah was in between these two great exiles, and the building was doomed from the very beginning, so why would Hashem choose this time out of all times to perform such amazing miracles? Why didn't Hashem choose a different time where the miracles would be more everlasting? Life is difficult. It presents us each with so many challenges, so many problems, so many issues. But when does life become overbearing? When do we lose the power and the patience to deal with life? This happens when things start to pile on top of each other. First it's one thing, then it's second, then it's another thing, then it's something else. We feel like we're carrying a terrible burden on our shoulders. We feel like the entire world is against us. It's in instances like this where we feel like we can't go on. But this is in fact the message of Chanukah. Hashem specifically created the miracles of Chanukah in this in-between time to teach us how to deal with life. The way to deal with life is not to allow things to pile onto each other. We need to separate our problems. We need to create, and we can create, breathing room. Even though the second Beis HaMikdash was sandwiched in between the times of exile, even though the second Beis HaMikdash was doomed to be destroyed, but Hashem granted us a temporary reprieve. We could enjoy that Beis HaMikdash for the time being. This is the secret to breaking up all of our problems and issues, to not allowing them to pile up, to decluttering our lives. When we think back to the earlier times and recall the kindness of Hashem, when we look at the situation right now and we see that silver lining, we see the little bit of consolation, then we can bring Hashem back into the picture. Then we can bring Hashem into our pain. When Hashem is there with us, we can then call out to Him, we can dive into Him, we can pray to Him, and then there's hope, and then there's salvation. This is the secret for life. It's the story of Chanukah. These are the miracles of Chanukah, and these are the miracles in all of our lives. We all have a very happy, happy Chanukah.